Hello, my name is Haralambos Simeonidis and I will present you the paper entitled as a UAV Video Data Generation Framework for Improved Robustness of UAV Detection Methods. UAVs have proven useful to many military and civilian applications. In many cases during flights, UAVs must be able to perceive the existence of other UAVs in their nearby airspace. This challenging task is often accomplished by visual object detectors. UAV detectors must be trained on multiple datasets in order to achieve an adequate level of robustness. However, several real-world datasets are relatively poor in terms of visual diversity, since they include only a single or small number of UAV models, or have been collected from specific and usually static viewpoints. Thus, in this work, we propose an effective and low-cost data generation method for UAV detection that reuses existing videos and documenting them with 3D UAV models, provides automatically generated annotations, and finally increases the robustness of UAV detectors. As input, the method requires a set of aerial videos. Such videos can be easily found on web or on pre-existing datasets. In addition, the method requires a set of 3D UAV models and a set of 3D models from various flying objects in order to be used as distractors. The virtual environment consists of a projection rectangle where the aerial background videos are projected, a virtual camera that records the entire process, a UAV model that moves in a spiral H-shaped trajectory, and distractors that also perform various trajectories between the camera and the projection plane. Finally, through this process, two debounding boxes of the depicted UAV models can be easily extracted as annotations for each frame. Using the proposed method, a dataset was generated based on the described assets. Overall, the dataset consists of 492 videos. Frames from our synthetic video dataset are depicted in this slide. Using the generated dataset, an experimental evaluation was conducted. In the first part, we examined whether our data are challenging for state-of-the-art detection frameworks. A YOLO V4 Tiny model was selected for this process. Overall, the detector was challenged where the size of the depicted UAV was small and when urban environments were depicted in the background videos. To conduct the second part of the experimental evaluation, we selected and modified three real-world UAV datasets. For each dataset, we created two training sets. The first training set contained only real-world images from the corresponding dataset, while the second set was augmented with a small number of images from our synthetic dataset. This task of this experimental evaluation was to assess the impact of our synthetic images as training data, along with real-world images, on the performance of UAV detection methods. Thus, two YOLO V4 models were trained for each real-world UAV dataset. The first model was trained on the training set which included only real-world images, while the second was trained on the augmented to synthetic images training set. Two types of evaluations were performed. In the intra-dataset evaluation, we assessed the impact of synthetic data in the performance of detection methods in the case where the training and the testing data were similar. In the inter-dataset evaluation, we examined the case where the testing set contained real-world images that were visually distinct from those on the training set. In the inter-dataset evaluation, it was shown that where our synthetic data were used as part of the training set, the performance of the detection method was decreased by a minimal amount. However, in the inter-dataset evaluation, it was demonstrated that a model trained on real and synthetic data can achieve an improved performance compared to being trained only on real. To our understanding, synthetic data alter the distribution of the original real-world training set, making thus the trained model more robust on visually dissimilar data. Before finalizing this presentation, I should mention that this work has received funding from the European Union's Horizon 2020 Research and Innovation Programme through the OpenDR project. Thank you for your attention.